This was about 1970 or late 1960s when I was the rabbi at the Hebrew Institute of University Heights in the Bronx. We had members, Ted Landsberg and his wife. His wife became ill. Her kidneys were still in good shape, but she was descending into the last days for sure. And in fact, she died a couple of days later. The doctor said she was certainly not going to live and not even communicate with him. And he said, please ask Rav Soloveitchik if she can donate both her kidneys. I said, you know, I assume that she cannot, because without those kidneys, she wouldn't be able to live altogether, even if she got well in other areas of her body. And I called the Rav. The Rav said, to my surprise, that she could donate both kidneys. That was the psak, is evident from the, I think for my whole existence, that the materializing of the answer to the shayla occurred that day, the next day, because they had to take the kidney and transplant it at once. They took both kidneys. One was given to a 70-year-old man. Another one was given to a 16-year-old girl.
Did you have an in-depth conversation with the Rav about it when you spoke with him? Did you tell him what state of being she was in? Was she...
Of course. I asked the Shaila the way a Rav should ask the Shaila. And that was, can she donate both her kidneys? She is certainly not going to live. Now, I know that Rav Aaron Soloveitchik poo-pooed it, and his nephew poo-pooed it, and the professor, whose name I can't remember, and they said that I probably misunderstood. Well, stupid I'm not, and misunderstood on such a critical shaila, I wouldn't misunderstand. And because I thought probably he would answer no, it's usher, I made sure to ask him clearly and to repeat what he told me. And he did. And it doesn't matter what Rabban says or what anybody else says on it being a misquoted or mistaken estimate or assessment that I personally made. I'm not part of the psak. I didn't say yes or no. I'm talking to the Rav, so what is my psak worth? But we talked about it, and I was of the opinion also then that both kidneys could not be taken, but what was what it was.
You were of that opinion before you spoke with the Rav?
Yes.
And then after you spoke with the Rav, you realized that he said you could.
So what was I going to do? He wanted it, and he said it was okay to do, and I did it.
Were you a student of Rav Soloveitchik?
Yes.
Uh-huh. And had you spoken with Rav Yosef Soloveitchik about other medical issues at other times?
Sure. You know, you ask a shaila, and you cannot misunderstand it, especially a shaila on such questions that are berumo shalolam. Right. They're beyond us. Right. I wasn't going to answer that kind of shaila.